excellence and dressing of tapered punches, more specifically my tapered punches. I'm holding a ruler here against the edge of this punch, and you can see the gaps as I bring it down, especially at the point, which is off to one side. There's a massive gap back here as well, which shows me the punch is by no means straight. Here, it's well away from the true. Now what I'm going to do is straighten that out. That's going to be quite hard, by heating it all to a dull red. And then I shall have to normalise it by burying it in the ash in the fire until it's cool. The same goes for the shorter one, the thicker punch. That is out at the bottom horribly. And I'm going to... horribly out at the bottom. This is through misuse. Right, I'll heat them up. I also need to deal with a fair old bit of mushrooming there as the struck enders spread. I'll do that on the grindstone when I dress the end. Entire thing to a dull red now. I'm going to start with the heavy end because that will hold the most heat. It can radiate back along to the small end. Change ends. Testing the colour in the shade of the heart. That's a nice dull red. Now just bury it in the ash. Oh, come here. Make sure I can find it again. Underneath there. Right, and the next one. That is pretty straight. Good up. Heat him up then. Bury this one as well. Leave them to cool. Probably take several hours. Right, the object here is to grind the end of the punch to achieve a parallel finish, and that means rotate it before it comes into contact with the wheel and keep on going. Get a square end on it. When you've got a square end, it'll be sharp. That is sharp. There we go then. Just deal with mushrooming on the other end. There we go then. That'll save any bits flying off. Job done. Yo.
I've got that end all ready. Change ends.
No. Oh-ho.